People have been asking me how I make cutscenes for Bravest Coconut, the action RPG I've been building. The short answer is my Dialog Manager add-on for Godot 4. The longer and probably more helpful answer is still Dialog Manager, but with a few examples. For those of you not familiar with Dialog Manager, the main thing to know is that in between lines of dialogue, you can call mutations, which are lines that call functions in your game, and in cases where relevant, wait for the function to finish before moving on. So let me show you. The first example is when Coco orders a drink from the cafe. There's some dialogue back and forward and some choices. Then Ben makes a drink and returns to deliver it. Let's break it down. In Dialog Manager, the script for this looks like this. This first part is simple dialogue which only happens the first time meeting Ben. Then we pick a random line from these three. Then we're given some choices. The choices themselves don't overly matter in this case. All of the drinks just give you full health. So let's assume the player picked T. First I call Coco.reach, which is just this little animation on Coco. The reason I can refer to the Coco object directly is because it is exposed on the current scene. The current scene being this inside cafe scene, which extends base scene, which defines Coco. Then I call cup.show, which makes this cup sprite visible. The cup variable is available for the same reason Coco was. It's exposed on the current scene. The result of these two lines is Coco reaching forward and placing her cup up on the bar. Then we have some more randomized dialogue. A basic line and a more obscure one. The basic line is twice as likely to be picked at random due to this %2 syntax. Then there's a state update behind the scenes to swap out the empty cup item in the inventory for one filled with tea. Then some more basic dialogue from Ben before he goes to make the drink. Now let's have a look at what this make drink mutation actually does. All it really does is play an animation, wait for it, then return to the idle animation. The await here is what tells Dialog Manager to let this animation play out before moving to the next line of dialogue. Ben then says, "Here you go," before Coco reaches up again to take the cup away. Then I check if this is the first time meeting Ben and say some different dialogue in each case. Lastly, I set the has met Ben flag to true. The result of all this is a smooth flowing little cutscene. The next example has a slightly more complicated setup. It uses some navigation stuff, but I'll get to that in a minute. First, let's see the whole thing in action. When choosing to use her lit torch next to the cauldron, Coco will run around to the front of it before pulling out the torch and lighting the cauldron. The dialogue script for this is mostly straightforward. If the nearest actionable node is the cauldron, then I check if it's already lit or even if it can be lit. If it's already lit, Coco says so. If it's not ready to be lit, then Coco informs you about that too. If it can be lit, then I first close the inventory. This do with the exclamation mark means to call this method but then advance without waiting for it to finish. Next, we tell Coco to move to the target position. This works by utilizing an acting state in Coco's state machine that uses a navigation agent to pathfind her way to the given target node's position. In order to use a navigation agent, we need to define a navigation region in the scene. The target in this case is this marker 2D node just below the cauldron. Once Coco reaches the target, she pauses for about half a second and then starts her use torch animation. Once that finishes, I tell the cauldron to start bubbling. Like before, the cauldron object is available to the dialogue because it has been defined in the current scene. Lastly, I pause for a short while before ending this path through the cutscene. If the cauldron isn't ready to be lit or if Coco isn't looking at the cauldron, then she will say some other helpful dialogue instead. As you can see from these examples, when using Dialog Manager, making cutscenes is mostly straightforward. Obviously, it depends on the specifics of how your game works, but Dialog Manager gives you everything you need to piece things together. Dialog Manager is available for free from the Godot Asset Library as well as GitHub. If you want to support the development of it or any of my other add-ons, then join my Patreon today. You'll also get access to a bunch of handy code snippets that I've shared. This month's Cockatoo patrons are Comrade Crunchy, Indie Rex, Mark Lassier, Skia, Vanillid, and Luki Pei. I hope I'm saying that correctly. Let me know if I'm not. And this month's OWL supporter is Mario J. Roberti. Thanks for your support. And now I have to get back to working on Bravest Coconut. In the meantime, don't forget to wishlist the game on Steam, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.